परमानेंट जॉइंट्स नॉन
नॉट
परमानेंट जॉइंट्स
नॉन परमानेंट जॉइंट। नेक्स्ट,
बाइंडिंग द ऑब्जेक्ट्स
बाइंडिंग द ऑब्जेक्ट, राइट। तो थ्रेडेड फैसनर्स, फैसनिंग। सो फैसनिंग मीन्स इट इज जस्ट टू जॉइन द कॉम्पोनेंट्स। ओके, इट इज जस्ट टू जॉइन द कॉम्पोनेंट्स। ओके, सो थ्रेडेड फैसनर्स मीन्स इट इज अ जॉइनिंग ऑफ द टू कॉम्पोनेंट्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ नट एंड बोल्ट, विद द हेल्प ऑफ नट एंड बोल्ट। ओके, सो बेसिकली यू आर गोइंग टू गेट अ टू टाइप ऑफ फैसनिंग मेथड्स हियर। यू आर गोइंग टू गेट अ टू टाइप ऑफ फैसनिंग मेथड्स। ओके, सो वन इज वॉट अ परमानेंट फैसनिंग। Permanent fastening. So second one is a temporary fastening. थ्रेडेड फैसनर्स मीन्स इट इज जस्ट ज्वाइनिंग। फैसनिंग मीन्स इट इज ज्वाइनिंग। ओके, सो फैसनर्स आर यूज टू ज्वाइन द कॉम्पोनेंट्स और मशीन पार्ट्स। ओके, सो एज अ सेड यू आर गोइंग टू गेट ए टू टाइप ऑफ फैसनिंग हियर। यू आर गोइंग टू गेट ए टू टाइप ऑफ फैसनिंग। सो वन इज वॉट परमानेंट फैसनिंग। So another one is temporary fastening. Okay. So here permanent fastening is done with the help of welding, riveting, welding, riveting, soldering, and brazing. Okay. So temporary fastening is done with the help of screws, studs, and bolt and nut. Bolt and nut. So permanent fastening is the one. So if you want to disassemble the components, so you need to damage it or you need to break down it. Okay. So that is what a permanent fastening. Temporary fastening. So in temporary fastening, you can easily unscrew, you can remove the studs, you can remove the bolt and nut, you can separate the components. Okay. So now in threaded fasteners, so you need to design the thread. You need to design the thread, okay, and its dimensions, right? Now as you come across, so you have a different type of threads here, you have a different types of thread forms. So what are the different type of thread forms? What are the different type of thread forms? So here you come across different type of thread forms. So basically we have two type of thread forms. One is what? Square thread form. So second one is V-shaped thread form. Okay. So now based on modification of this square thread form as well as V-shaped thread form, you are going to get another different type of thread forms. Okay. So here you are going to get a square thread. You are going to get a square thread here. Okay. So you are going to get a Acme. You are going to get a Acme. So here you are going to get modified as ISO. BSW, okay, BSW. One more is I think here you are going to get a one more type. This is what a knuckle thread. Okay, you are going to get a knuckle thread. So here you are going to get a BISO, BSW, and butters thread. Okay? Butters thread. Okay. So now butters thread is what a combination of this V shape as well as the square shape. Okay. V shape as well as the square shape, right? So now let us look at the terminology of screw thread. Okay, terminology of screw thread. So you need to take it as exact straight lines, so not an curved lines. Okay. So what are the dimensions you are going to get here? This is what major diameter. This is also called as a nominal diameter. Okay. So the diameter which is going to be measured here with respect to the root. Okay. With respect to the root. That means from this position. From this position, so this is called as a root diameter, okay, or minor diameter. This is called as a root diameter or minor diameter. Okay. So this is what minor diameter. So now in between these two, so you are going to get a pitch diameter. So you are going to get a pitch diameter or mean diameter. Pitch diameter or mean diameter. So now the distance which is to be measured from one crest to another crest. Okay. So what it is called as? What it is called? Distance measured between conjugative crest or conjugative root. It is termed as what?
Pitch.
So what it is termed? So this is noted as a pitch. Pitch. So then this is what depth of thread. Depth of thread. Okay. So now this is called as a crust. And this portion is called as a root. And this is called as the angle which is to be measured with respect to the vertical plane. Okay, so it's called an helix angle. Okay. It's called helix angle. Okay, so either it may be of left, either it may be of right. Okay. Either it may be of right. Okay. Now particularly in this section, so you need to design the minor diameter. You need to design the minor diameter. Okay. So because this minor diameter is the weakest section, okay. So now this is a minimum portion which is going to subject it to the maximum stress. Which is going to subject it to maximum stress. So you need to calculate what is the minor diameter or core diameter. Okay. Minor diameter or core diameter. Right. So we can just define in your own way. So major diameter is the diameter of the bolt, okay, so which is of equal to the normal diameter of the shank portion. Okay, so minor diameter is a diameter which is to be measured between the roots, between the roots. Okay, so pitch diameter or mean diameter is the average diameter of the major diameter and minor diameter. Okay, so crust is a portion, so where it is going to give the so maximum dimensions of the bolt. Okay, so root is a portion, or root is a intersection of these two slopes where you are going to give the minor diameter of the bolt. So next, pitch is what? It is defined as the distance measured between two conjugative crest or root. Okay, so depth of thread, it is the vertical difference between the or the vertical distance of the thread profile. Okay, suppose if you consider one thread profile here. Okay, so now this is what a depth of thread. Okay, this is what depth of a thread. Okay. So angle between here, it may be of a 60 degree or it may be of 55 degree. Okay, so it is based on whether you need to follow the BSW thread or ISO thread. Okay, or modified ISO threads. Right. So now the what are the stresses? Okay, stresses induced in thread because of initial tightening. Some slope here. Okay. So now profile is not an exact
Sorry, no, Kerala one, sir. Hello.
Excuse me,
Hello.
Sir.
Sir, why is Gatila, sir?
Why is low, Bharat?
Hello. Hello. Now audible?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Okay. So now we'll discuss the initial. What are the stresses are going to develop because of initial tightening of the thread profile or the bolt? Now to tighten the bolt. So what you are applying, what you are going to apply over the bolt, I'll just remind you one example. So if you went for the bolt cleansing of your tire, okay, so you are going to remove the entire wheel, right? Yoga karinda puncture agittandre pura gali horagade tegitara, sarina? ಎಸ್ ಸರ್ ನೋ
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್
ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನ ತೆಗಿಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ ನಾಲ್ಕು ನಟ್ ಉಸ್ತೀರಾ ನಟ್ ಉಸ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ ಪಾನ ತಗೋತೀರಿ ಸೊ ಪಾನ ತಗೊಂಡು ಟರ್ನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ ಹೌದಾ ಸೊ ಟರ್ನ್ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ನಟ್ ಉಸ್ತದೆ ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ಲಿ ವಾಪಸ್ ಅದನ್ನ ಫಿಕ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಪಾನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ ಪಾನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ ಪಾನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಟರ್ನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ ಓಕೆ So as you go on turning, so you are going to apply the torque over that nut, okay, or a bolt. So that causes some initial stresses set up in the thread, okay. So now let us notify here. I'll go with one by one. We'll go with one by one. Okay. Let us consider one bolt here. Let us consider one bolt. Okay. So as you're providing a torque, okay, as you're providing torque, if you are tightening here, if you are tightening, okay, if you are tightening, so what happens along its axis, along its axis. So as you go on compressing the crust portion as well as root portion here, as you're giving this one, it try to compress. So this causes some tensile stress in the bolt. This causes some tensile stress in the bolt. Okay. So it's going to give you some axial deflection in upward directions, because you are forcing the thread or you are forcing the bolt as to get move towards inward. So to move towards inward, so that causes the initial tensile stress in the component. Okay. Right. So now, how you can calculate the tensile stress due to stretching of the bolt? You got idea. So as giving some torque, so as try to compress and get inside. Okay. So that compression force causes to stretch this bolt in upward direction. Stretch this portion upward direction. So that is what makes a tensile stress. That means it tried to pull out outside. As you're giving, you try to get inside the all thread forms. Okay. So now it's going to give the tensile stress here. So now this tensile stress is calculated based on the load. Okay. So the initial tensile or the initial tension load. Okay? So the initial tension load. Okay? You can calculate based on experiment. They are given on formula. So they have given a formula. So that is what Pi equal to 2840 d. Okay. This is what in terms of Newton. Okay. So now Pi is initial tension in a bolt. And D is nominal diameter of bolt. Okay. D is a nominal diameter of the bolt. Okay. So now we have two cases here. Suppose if you are using this bolt without gasket or without leak proof joint. So you bolt in use maadthire neevu vandu metal to metal contact maadi tight maadthire. Metal to metal contact. Example, so assembling of your car wheel. Okay. So in some cases you are going to use this combination metal to gasket. Okay. Then or any, you can say the intermediate material, okay, metal to gasket, then gasket to metal. Okay. So on that cases, the initial tension is going to get, or the initial tension load you are going to get is a different. Okay. You're going to get a different. Okay. So example, if you gone for the steam engine cylinder, or the you can take example of the two-wheeler engine. Okay, So engine head is fitted with the help of some gasket here. So on that cases, you can calculate. So the initial load, okay, or the initial stretching load, Pi equal to 1420 d. Okay, 1420 d. This is in terms of Newton. In design data handbook you have equations, so there is some slightly change in values here. Okay, so in design data handbook you have equations, some slightly modified value here. I think it is 2841D. I think it is a 2841D. Okay, so we'll look out the values as well as the proportions while solving the problems. Okay, now suppose if you know the initial tensile load, how much it is going to exert, if you have the permissible stress of the bolt material, okay, or the allowable stress of the bolt material, now you can easily find out what is the diameter of a bolt required for this load. What is the diameter of a bolt required to carry out this load? Okay. So now we go next here. I'll just go for the equation here. Okay. Suppose if a sigma A is permissible stress of bolt material, okay, if PI is the initial tension or the initial tensile load of the material, then you can calculate the load carrying capacity of this bolt material, load carrying capacity of this bolt material. Okay, so P equal to what? Sigma into A, right? P equal to sigma into A. Now PI equal to sigma A into A, so where A is cross sectional area, it is what? Cross sectional area of the bolt. Okay, so A equal to what? Cross sectional area of bolt. Okay, so that is what in core diameter, that is what at core diameter. Okay, so some authors took it as a mean area also, some author took it as a mean area. So that is what dp plus dc divided by 2, okay, so into pi by 4. Okay, they have gone for this one. So some author gone for 5 by 4 dc square, pi by 4 dc square. So now if you equate values here, okay, so now pi equal to p, okay, this is equal to what? Sigma A into A. Now let us substitute. So p equal to sigma A into pi by 4 dc square. Now by this equation you can calculate 4p divided by sigma A into pi. Okay, now dc equal to, it is what here. Okay, now by this equation you can calculate directly the core diameter of the bolt, core diameter of the bolt, right? Next, so another one, as you're giving some torque, okay, so as you're giving some torque, so it is going to be subjected to shear stress also. It is going to be subjected to shear stress also. So in this case, as because of initial stress, so it may fail. It may fail. Just some portion may come out. Okay, so it is going to come out here. It is going to break out on this position. It is going to break out on this position, right? This is what the tensile stress induced in the bolt or thread form because of the stretching of bolt. Okay? Because of stretching, okay, of bolt. Right. So second case. So torsional shear stress. Torsional shear stress caused by the frictional resistance of the threads during its tightening. During its tightening. So now in this case, if you consider, I'll just go for a front view here, okay? I'll go for a top view, not a front view, top view. Now, with the help of spanner, you are giving some torque here. You are giving some torque, right? So, as you are providing the torque, okay? So, as you are providing the torque, let us take here, okay? Now, because of the frictional resistance, because of the frictional resistance at root level, at a root level, let us take an example here. It is at some position of root level. Now it is what it is a fixed here, okay? It is fixed here. If you give the torque here, if you give the torque, it is going to break out here. It is going to break out. Okay? So now let us see. Now it has been cut out, it has been broken out, so because of torque here, because of torque. So now how are we going to get the torsional shear stress? How are we going to get the torsional shear stress? What is the relation to get the torsional shear stress? Someone reply. So T by J equal to tau by R. Now torque is calculated based on the length of the spanner, okay, and how much load you are going to apply, okay. So now in this case, the value of shear stress. So let us rewrite for value of shear stress here. Okay. Shear stress equal to what? T divided by ZP. Okay, so here ZP equal to what? J by R. This is what? Polar section modulus. Polar section modulus. So what is the value of polar section modulus? ZP equal to pi by 16 d cube. Okay, pi by 16 d cube. So now let us substitute here. So tau equal to T divided by pi by 60 d cube. Now you rewrite here. So d equal to cube root of 16 t divided by pi into tau. Pi into tau. Now the diameter you are going to get here is a core diameter. Diameter you are going to get here is core diameter. So what you got here? So the core diameter dc equal to cube root of 16 t divided by pi into tau. So in this case, t equal to torque applied. Okay. So this is in terms of Newton mm. Tau is the allowable or permissible shear stress of bolt material, right? Shear stress of bolt material, right? You got where T is torque applied, tau is allowable shear stress or permissible stress of the bolt material. Okay. Next, another one case as. You have a variation in cross sections here, okay? So the possibility of burning out the thread forms takes place. the possibility of worn out of the thread forms takes place. Okay, so this is what. So one thing is, now you have seen it is going to failure in this direction. Okay, that is what at core diameter. Okay, one more thing is the possibility of worn out of the all thread forms. Okay, the third one is the shear stress across the threads. Shear stress across the threads. Okay? Look out here. So now this is what the core diameter, okay, or the root diameter. So now this is what major diameter. This is what major diameter. Okay. Now, as they were giving torsion, if this particular section is a weaker one, okay, this particular section is a weaker one. So it is going to worn out this entire thread forms. It is going to worn out entire thread forms. So if the thread forms are worn out, so it just look like a cylinder here. Your thread, your bolt is just what a plain one. It is what a plain one, right? So on that cases, it is going to shear out. It is going to shear out the thread forms along its core diameter. Along its core diameter. Okay. So now, how are you going to calculate that value? Now what is the area of one thread here? So what is the area of one thread? What is the area of one thread? Area of one thread. Am I audible or not? Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So now, what is the area of one thread? Now, area of one thread is what the perimeter of this profile. Okay. Then only one complete thread form is going to worn out. Okay. So let us take. So pi d is the perimeter, b is the width of the thread form. Okay. Into n is what number of threads on that particular port. N is number of threads on the particular port. Okay. So now this is what area. This is what A. If P is the load, okay, P is the load, this may be of because of a tensile load. Because of stretching, you are going to get the some load, that is what PI. That is what PI. So P equal to load. Okay. So let us calculate here PS. For your understanding purpose, let us take it as a PS is the load which is going to cause the shearing of the thread forms. Now the shear stress here, tau equal to, you can go for across thread as a tau t or tau th. This is equal to what? Ps divided by area. Stress equal to what? Load by area, right? Stress equal to load by area. So now this is equal to what? Pi dc b into n, where so dc is what? Core diameter. Dc is core diameter in mm. Okay, so b is width. B is width of the thread form. Okay. So B is width of the thread form. Okay. Width of thread at root. Let us take it as a root. Okay. So because this dimension is available at root. Now this is what B here. This is what B. Next N is number of threads. N is number of threads on board. You will get the shear stress across the threads. Shear stress across the threads. Right? Next. Next one is, you have a possibility of crushing out this threads here. Crushing out these threads. So example, if you take these thread forms, okay, we'll try next diagram. So let us go for next one. So compression or crushing stress on threads. Compression or crushing threads, crushing of threads, okay. This is about a crushing stress on threads. Okay. Now just look out here. Suppose if the load is going to act on this direction is what? It's a tensile load because of initial tensioning. If it is of more, then if it compresses, okay, and if compresses here, and if these thread forms are worn out along this direction, okay. So now what happens if the area is more here, okay? If the area is more here, so now these thread forms become weaker here. Weaker here. That means if the height is more, okay? If the height of thread is more, these areas are become weaker. So what happens if it's apply the tension force? So this portion is going to be worn out. This portion is going to be worn out, okay? So that is what stress due to compression. Now they are made going to make these separated as so hollow circles or hollow plane objects. Okay, so they will worn out or they will crush out in this area. In this area, okay. So in this direction only they are going to sustain the compression stress. Okay, this area. Okay. So if they fail, you are going to get the failure of the thread forms in this manner. Okay. So now what is the area here? Now this is what a DC. Okay. So now this is what a DO already. Right? Now let us find out here. Okay. So the compression stress or crushing stress between the threads, okay, is obtained by now, so the compression stress or crushing stress on the threads, stress between the threads, okay? Between the threads between the sets obtained by the relation sigma c equal to p divided by pi by 4 d square here, that is what nominal diameter. Minus dc square, okay, into n here, into n. So when complete failure occurs, when all these, let us say you have a four number of thread forms here, if it fails one, no, it is not, bolt is not completely failed. When it is going to completely fail, when all these four threads are to be crushed out, okay, so then only failure occurs. Now in this case, so here d is what? It is a major diameter. Major diameter. Okay. So in mm, dc is what? A core diameter. Dc is core diameter. So n is number of thread forms. Number of threads. Okay. Not a forms, number of threads. So now number of threads may be variable. You may get a 16, 20. Now all these number of threads have to be in engage. In a engage. Example, if you fitted with a nut here, if you fitted with the nut, even though if you have a four number of more number of thread forms here, okay, so then the failure occurs only on these four threads. Okay, so you can say number of threads in engagement. Okay, in engagement. Right. Next, the last one is there. Last one. You are going to get a bending stress. Okay? You are going to get a bending stress. So bending stress is going to occur when the surface of a bolt and the surface of the component which are to be assembled or fastened, if they are not parallel, you are going to get a bending stress. We are going to get a bending stress. Okay. So, bending stress, if the surface is under the head or nut. Are not perfectly parallel to bolt axis. Parallel to the bolt axis. Okay. Let us take an example here. Now this is what a component is here, okay. It has thread hole is here, that means thread form is here, okay. Now we need to fix a bolt in this nut portion or a component portion, okay. Now, if axis of this one, okay, if axis of this one is not parallel or is not coincident to the bolt, is not coincident to the bolt. Let us take example, if we fix it, it's going to get in this shape. It's going to get in this shape, right? So then you are going to get some eccentricity here. You are going to get some eccentricity. So that eccentricity is what? X. So now all this depends on the surface, okay? Surface of this portion as well as this head portion are to be same, okay? along with that one, so the axes are to be in a coincident, so they should not have any deflection. If they have a deflection, automatically we are going to get some deviation. So that deviation causes the bending stress. So now let us notify the formula here. So if you consider x, as the object distance, then the bending stress. Now the bending stress. So sigma b equal to x into e divided by 2l. Okay. So now x is what they are given different here. Difference in height between the extreme corners of the nut or head. So as you got a deflection, so if these surfaces are not a parallel, you are going to get some distance here. That distance, they are saying it as x. Now extreme corners here, so sometimes if bolt is has a this level and if the nut has an another level here, okay, another level, so then this distance is what, x. So automatically if you consider the excesses here, now you're going to get a deflection as a x here. Okay, so e is what, x modulus of the material. E is Young's modulus of bolt material. Now this is what in terms of mm. Now this is Newton per mm square. Okay. So next L is what? So length of the shank of the bolt. This is in mm. Okay. So we'll stop here. We'll just give the attendance.